Hi there, I'm Nils from learntodiy.com, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a good-looking and good-sized planter box for under $23. Now, when I drew up the plans for this planter box, I wanted to make sure it was big enough to accommodate a good variety of flowers or whatever types of plants you wanted to put in here. This is something that would look great on a porch, perhaps on a patio, in a front yard, or even in a garden. So this thing is pretty simple. It's really basically made out of some pickets from cedar that you can buy at the hardware store, as well as a 2x4. There's not a lot to it. I'll include download plans for this with everything you need on my website at learntodiy.com. Be sure to check out the links in the description below to get straight to it. Also, if there's any products that you see in this video that you're interested in, I'll have links for those in the description as well. Now for the supplies for this project, you're gonna need 9 Western Red Cedar pickets. These guys are less than $2 a piece. There's also a $3 option. You'll just need 9 of those, as well as 1 2x4. It's just gonna be your standard 8-foot 2x4, kind of you can get for about $3. Once we've got our supplies, the first step is to build a small frame. This is what's gonna go on the inside and hold up the bottom shelf. To do this, take a 2x4 and rip it right in half. You can use a table saw or a skill saw to do this. Then cut down your lengths. Make sure you let the boards fall, because all the cool kids do that. And then also, if you need dimensions for this, just be sure to check out my website where you can get the dimensions and plans for all this. Next up, pre-drill the holes and then use 3-inch wood screws to fasten the 4 pieces together. Once you've got your frame put together, we're ready to put 6 floorboards essentially on it. We're going to leave a little gap between each one, but this should work out really nicely. Cut them to size, you'll need 6 total, and then pre-drill and then screw in these 6 pieces to the frame that you've just created. Next up, we'll do the inner frame, which is just 4 pieces of wood that we're going to use to put our siding on. So cut those out on the chop saw, just like before, and then again we're going to use 3-inch screws to fasten them from the bottom side of our floor. Next up, siding. For this, we're going to cut 6 longer pieces and 6 shorter pieces, so it'll be 3 on each side, and then you're going to wrap them all around. I would recommend using a brad nailer with this, with some 2-inch 18 gauge brads. You can also use screws, and you're going to have some dog ears on here, and that's okay, because those will get covered up by your corner pieces. Then we're going to put our feet on, so just cut those to size as per the plans. Use some brad nails or small screws to get those in place for now. We'll fasten those a little bit better once we put the siding on. Speaking of which, we're going to set the table saw to about 2 1/8 inches, I found worked best, and at a 45 degree angle for the blade, and that'll give us 2 pieces that are 45 degrees and roughly the same size. Then we're going to take those, use the chop saw, and cut them into quarters, and those become our corner pieces. I'd recommend you put at least 2 screws in each. You can do more if you'd like. I used 3-inch screws here and they're a little bit long, so I might go with maybe a 2-inch if you have those available. Even a 1 1/2 inch would probably do the job. Now with our last piece, we're gonna create the top frame. We're gonna rip that in half on the table saw and then get your measurements, your width and your length for the top of the box. Make sure to get the outside measurements because we want the longest of each of the width and length measurements. Using the miter saw, cut these at a 45 degree angle so that you're basically creating like a big picture frame. Once you've got those cut, we're going to place them on top of the planter box and actually tack those together like a picture frame to one another. From there, we can position it just right on the top of the planter box to make sure that the frame covers up the entire top of the planter box. Okay, now wrapping up, if you want to, you can put some weed barrier in there like we've done here. This is optional, but I thought it might help hold the dirt in a little bit better. Make sure to cut some holes in the weed barrier at the bottom for drainage if you do use it. And then you can put about 3 bags of potting soil in here, and then whatever plants you want. And that's it. If you choose to do so like we did, we actually used water sealer all around them just to make sure that the open faces that we cut were nice and sealed. And hopefully these things will last us for many years. They're very sturdy and will look great in a variety of locations.